Hi, this is Kit Payne, your speaker coach and the founder of Boston Speaks. Let's talk about five tips to improve your public speaking. First tip is use notes, actually. Most of the time, I'm using notes myself. Most of the time, people don't know how to use notes effectively when they have to speak in public. But there's one good thing about using notes. It helps you gain more clarity and helps you follow through on what you have to present. Here are the things that you have to know about using notes. When you have notes, no matter if it's 30 pages or one page, you want to keep eye contact with your audience in two important ways, in the introduction and in the conclusion. When you first begin a talk, don't just look at, imagine I'm looking at my notes, or when this video started, I would say, hey everyone, this is Kit Payne, your speaker coach, and you know, it's a little bit different than me looking at you and saying, hey, this is Kit Payne. So when you are presenting, connect with your audience in the introduction, because that's one of the most important times where people can feel like, wow, this person is actually talking and addressing us. So keep eye contact at the beginning of your introduction and also when you end your talk. So throughout the time when you're using notes, you can basically go, good morning everyone, my name is Kit Payne, and today I want to talk to you about public speaking. And one of the most important things I want to talk to you about is this one important part is called preparation. You see how I'm just looking back and looking at you at the same time? You can do the same exact thing. So if you watch, there are some people, let's say on YouTube, their video's gone viral. And you might not have noticed this, but they are using notes. Or even if you watch those late night shows of David Letterman and those folks, you know how many, you know the amounts of notes that they have on their desk, okay? You just don't notice them because they're such a good presenter and speaker, they know how to flow in the spot. So when you use the notes, don't just look at your notes the whole time. Engage your audience while you look back and look at your audience back and forth. But this also takes practice, so as you are preparing your talk, have your notes in front of you, look at them, look back at the audience. The second tip I want you to have when you want to make your public speaking better is to actually make your body language a little bit bigger. Most of the time, if you don't feel as confident, people will come on a talk when they first begin, their body language might be a little bit smaller. And they might, again, there's nothing wrong with making your body language small or having it in like this, but just like, let's say two animals are fighting. When they first see each other and they want to go for that fight, they make themselves a little bit bigger, so they will appear to, you know, the other animal of, wow, they're really confident in what they have. It's the same exact thing as a speaker. When the first thing that you do, you walk up to a stage or you're going up to present, how can you make your body language just a little bit bigger? In your mind, it might seem super, super big, but to the audience, you actually give them a lot more energy. So if you keep your hands always within the box, right? I call this the box. It's in a normal conversation. Our hands are flowing like this. Maybe when you first begin, you can say, hey, good morning. Today I want to talk to you about your public speaking. Just a little bit of this will make you feel a lot more energetic. It will make the audience feel a lot more energetic. And here's the thing, it's very hard for me not to be energetic when my hands are a little bit bigger. You'll also feel a lot more confident and you'll feel a lot more happier and better about yourself when you do make this body language a little bit bigger. It's just like if you were to win the Olympics, you won't be in a small body position. You'll just probably be happy and your body language will be a little bit bigger, okay? So start off your body language a little bit bigger. It's also like if you're running a race and you start walking in the beginning, it's gonna be hard to catch up. The third tip, if you want to become a better speaker, is to watch your pronouns. More specifically, I, you, and we. So I wanna do a little demonstration. I'm gonna start saying all I's, and then I'm gonna stop. Start with the same content, but use the word you. I'm gonna stop again, and then use the pronoun we, okay? So, my name is Kit Payne, and I am a public speaking coach. I help individuals with their public speaking, their body language, their storytelling, and what I love about my work is I can really see that people get that sparkle in the eyes when they really feel like, wow, I've got it, or wow, I really feel confident. So at the end of the day, I really enjoy helping people improve their public speaking. So I'm gonna stop and start with you. So you're watching this video, or if you're still watching, you probably care about your public speaking and about your growth. And after helping so many individuals, I can say that they might have the same challenges that you might have when it comes to your public speaking, whether if it's your body language, your storytelling, how you present information. At the end of the day, I would love to see it when you get into that moment, and maybe you have that sparkle in your eye, or you have that feeling in your head when you're saying, yes, I've got it, okay? So as a public speaking coach, I'm here to help you step up your game when it comes to your public speaking. So I'm gonna stop, use the word we. We are here because we want to improve our public speaking. Even myself, I wanna improve on my body language. Maybe we want to work on the same things like our storytelling skills. So at the end of the day, how can we actually help each other improve our public speaking? We can give each other feedback. Although we're in different spaces right now, we can still comment, right? Give each other feedback, our thoughts on the way we speak, how we sound. So at the end of the day, let's help each other grow in our public speaking. So again, I, you, and we, of course there's they too, but if you want to become a better speaker, don't just use one pronoun, have it like a roller coaster. It goes up, it goes down. Use I, use you, use we, use they. When you use the word you, your audience will be more captured immediately. Their ears will just perk up. When you use the word we, it's more of a community feeling. When you use the word I, you have to share a little bit about yourself. People will learn more about you. When you use the word they, okay, let's say they versus us, you really make a separation of, hey, this is what we're going for, and their challenges. So you kind of build that team community as well. The fourth tip, if you want to become a better speaker, is to take a breath. Sometimes you have so much information that you want to talk about, it's kind of like on autopilot, and you forget to breathe and calm yourself down and actually say what's on your mind. Because when you're not breathing, you can't think as clear. When you're not thinking as clear, of course, this could happen when you're nervous or sometimes when you're in the moment. Remind yourself to just keep your pacing, keep a pause, and slow down, because you can think more clearly and you can speak more clearly. There's an artist that once asked, how do you know who's the most confident person in the room? The person who knows how to control his or her breath. Even if you were, let's say, a voice actor or voice actress, if you don't take a breath, you won't be able to even read one chapter. And it's the same thing with public speaking. Maybe some of you just want to talk so much, you forget that the audience also need a little time to take in what you say. So really, add that breath to your speaking. And the fifth tip, if you really want to become a better speaker, you have to improve your storytelling skills. Storytelling is one of the most important things that you can add in any of your talk, in any areas. If you are in finance, in science, in marketing, in sales, as human beings, we are wired for stories. We share stories to help each other learn. We share stories to help each other grow. And we share stories so that we can learn a little bit about ourselves and each other. So when you do share a story, think about a good story this way. Do you remember, you can tell a personal story, right? The last time you were really happy. The last time you were really sad, okay? In a personal story, you wanna go right into that situation. There are also two other types of stories. You can tell stories about other people, or you can share a case study, like a research, okay? So three types of stories: a personal story, a story about other people, or a case study. So I hope that you enjoy these five tips. Let me know what tip that you would like to incorporate in your day today or this week, and I'd love to hear how you're doing with it.